students, today we'll just do the numericals on kinetic energy. We have already given you the notes and the derivation for kinetic energy, work energy theorem in the previous video. So let us see the first one. If the momentum of an object of mass 20 kg is 50 kg meter per second, find its kinetic energy. So what is given here is momentum. Momentum is denoted by P. So, momentum is given as 50 kg meter per second and mass of the object is given as 20 kgs. And we need to find the kinetic energy. Kinetic energy means we need to find the value of half mv square. This we have to find out. Children, now what is the formula for kinetic energy? So kinetic energy is half mv square, right? Mass I know, but velocity I do not know. Instead of velocity, what is given? Momentum. So you know that momentum means P is equal to m into v, right? Now see here, I'm going to do some changes here. What I'm going to do? I am going to multiply and divide by one extra m, means I'm making it m by m, right? So this will become half m into m will become m square, v square, and in the denominator also you have m. Now if I just make it square, so this will become p square is equal to m square v square. So instead of m square v square, I can write p square divided by 2m. So this is the formula for kinetic energy when momentum and mass is given. You can directly remember this or you can do it with the manipulation. So we can substitute for this. This is p square. P square is 50 square upon 2m. 2 into m is what? 20 kg. When you substitute, you will get 62.5 joules. Kinetic energy is measured in joules. Let's do one more on the kinetic energy. Read the question. A body of mass 5 kg, a body of mass 5 kg is initially at rest. Initially at rest means U is 0. Is subjected to a force of 20 newton. So F value is 20 newton. What is the kinetic energy acquired by the body at the end of 10 seconds? So time is 10 seconds and we need to find the kinetic energy, that is half mv square. Children, to find kinetic energy, m is given to us, but I don't know the value of final velocity v. So first I need to calculate the velocity v. So how should I do it? You know the equation, F is equal to m into a, right? So acceleration will be equal to F upon m, because the body is starting from rest and it is acquiring certain velocity. So definitely it will have certain acceleration a. So we need to calculate how much the body has been accelerated. So acceleration will be F upon m. F is how much? F is 20. Upon m is 5, so it is 4 meter per second square. Now what I need to calculate? I need to calculate the value of v. So using equation of motion, v is equal to u plus at. Second step. So first step we calculated a. Second step I'll calculate the value of v. So v equals, now initial velocity, it is given, it is at rest, plus a into t. So 4 into how much time it has been accelerated? 10 seconds. So 10. So final velocity v is 40 meter per second. So last step. Therefore, the kinetic energy. Now we are calculating the kinetic energy and it is given by half mv square. Half m is 5 and v is what? 40 into 40. So this you can cancel, 2, 20 is a, so 4, 2 is a 8, 8, 5 is a 40. 4000
joule.
Children, let us do the third one here. What is given? Two bodies of equal masses move with uniform velocities v and 3v respectively. Find the ratios of their kinetic energy. So when we need to find the ratios, what I'll do is we can calculate individually the kinetic energy of the first body and the second body, and then we can find the ratio. So kinetic energy of first body will be, formula is what? Half mv square. So half m, and what is the velocity of the first body? V square. So kinetic energy of the first body is half mv square. Directly we can write. But what about the kinetic energy of second body? So kinetic energy of second body, the formula is half mv square, right? So half, instead of m, because they are having the equal masses, so I will denote it by m only. Both of them are having the equal masses, so we have written it m only. Now v, so but instead of v square, I have to write 3v square, isn't it? Velocity is 3v for the second body. So this will be half m into 9v square. Or we can write it as 9 times half mv square. Correct? Now, what is the question? Find the ratios of their kinetic energy. So kinetic energy of first body divided by kinetic energy of the second body. So what is the kinetic energy of first body? It is half mv square. And what is the kinetic energy of the second body? It is 9 times half mv square. So these two will get cancelled. So it is, the ratio will be 1:9.